Welcome back to my channel. I'm a little embarrassed, you guys, because, well, I went MIA again. And I know I look a little rough, but that's just how I'm gonna be looking right now. I feel like life has just gotten in the way. And I'm gonna explain. So this is gonna be like a life update while I get ready. Hi. Hi. And my baby is here. Also, you guys, this angle is like this is because one, my baby actually broke my tripod. So I literally had to like tape it down. And then two, I was gonna put it, And then two, I was gonna put the tripod on the side here, but because my baby is like walking around, it's not gonna work because he's like bumping into it and it just keeps tipping over. But that's okay because my baby could do whatever he wants because he's so handsome. You're so handsome? Okay. So basically, yeah, today, hey, you want to be the star of the show? Yeah, okay. I actually took a nap with my baby today, which I never do, but I was like, I really want to do a video of just like a life update. I want to do my hair. I want to clean up. I want to catch you guys up on everything. And then I was like, yeah, but you guys, I'm 8 months postpartum, you guys. 8 months, 8 months. My baby is 8 months old.
What? What the?
So yeah, can you guys believe that? I can't. Babita, you are 8 months old, my baby? Explain to you guys everything that has been going on, and yeah, I'm gonna just update you guys, so let's just get right into it. Okay, so I think this is a better angle. Let me tell you guys, postpartum really is postpartum really is a combination of a lot of things. You're in charge of a little human being, which is amazing, you know? And then on top of that, so like, it's the baby, it's your relationship, it's yourself, it's maintaining your home, it's finding your style again. Like, girl, I don't even have a style anymore. Like, I don't even know what I like. I don't even know what I don't like. Oh my gosh, hi. Mommy's doing her hair. You know, therapy. You know, I started going to therapy because of it. It was just very hard. And especially when you completely have no support whatsoever, I think it makes it a little bit harder. And I want to say support like on both ends of the family, like his dad's side, my side. Your relationship doesn't make it through postpartum. And sometimes it does, you know, that's like great. I mean, at the end of it, maybe people try to work things out, but it's still hard, you know? It's like so hard when the woman's like body is like healing. You're going through so many emotions, like hormones, and at the same time, like, you're trying to be a mom, like, you're trying to just navigate through all these things. Are you okay, my love? Give me a sec. Really just takes a toll on, like, your mental health. Like, postpartum depression is real. Spam of 8 months has been it's just been really crazy, you guys. Like, I don't even know where the time has gone. And then with having a baby, it's like comes with like so much with your baby, like newborns, right? You're trying to figure out like how to deal with the newborn stage. You know, the newborn stage is really the hardest. And you know, are you breastfeeding? Are you formula feeding? Like, is your baby breathing? It's just so much, honestly, that goes into like being a parent, having mom guilt or dad guilt, whatever, you know. If you're a guy watching this, and you don't really understand where I'm coming from, I don't expect you to, but you can just,
okay, bye,
click out the video, because it's really hard for men to understand what a woman is going through, like especially after birth, even during birth, labor and all that. Like, it's really just hard for them to understand. Is the baby eating enough? And then boom, you're celebrating like 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, 4 month, and then you hit like the, I don't know, 4 month regression, sleep regression, right? Which is like their sleeping schedules are just out of place. And then on top of that, you're dealing with people wanting to see your baby, but it's like really, I don't know, it's really hard, you guys. I mean, I really put a stop to that, like people seeing my baby, because I was just really going through it, honestly. I was just really going through it, and like people just want to be there for my baby during the good times, not the bad times, you know what I mean? And I don't think, like, no, goodbye. Where was I? Sleep regression, right? 4 months, and now you're celebrating 5 months, 6 months, now they're freaking teething, and you're not sleeping, and yeah, they're teething. I'm complaining at all. Like, I've enjoyed every single moment with my baby, and I'm very thankful that I'm a stay-at-home mom. I work from home, and I'm very, very, very fortunate and thankful that I get to be home with my baby. So it's not me complaining, it's just like me explaining to you guys like what really has been 8 months of craziness. And so yeah, like my baby, he hit all those milestones, right? And then after that, like, okay, teething, and then now my baby like developed like this rash not too long ago, and then you just start freaking out like, what is going on? And then on top of that, we got sick, you guys. Was it last week or 2 weeks ago? No, yeah, last week we got sick, and it was like so hard, like, because at the same time, like for me, I was so sick and I was so weak, like, for all that madness, like my baby. So now we're feeling a little bit better. We have recovered. It was literally just like the common cold. My baby was sick for like, I want to say like 3 days. It wasn't honestly that much. I want to say like 3 to 4 days. And then I got sick literally right after him. And I really was feeling it. Like, I felt like everything was just coming down to me. Like, it was just so much. Like, my body was weak. I was weak, like, in general. Like, and as a parent, like, you just have to really tough it out. Like, it's crazy. When you have, like, no support around you, you really just have to tough it out. And I kept reminding myself that, you know, I'm very fortunate that I'm here with him, but it for sure, you lose your mind. Even as a stay-at-home mom, like, you're losing your mind. Like, you're losing your mind. 24/7. It just gets stressful. Like, still being a stay-at-home mom, but working from home, like, you're trying to... I think postpartum has been the most humbling for me. And the most, like, how can I explain it? Just very eye-opening for me. like, of just life in general, the people I want in my life, how I want to live my life, what's important and what's not, who's important and who's not important, and, you know, just, it's been 8 months, and every single month I always ask myself, like, how do people do it with, like, a gazillion kids? Like, I really truly want to know, like, you really have to have, like, some sort of superpower to deal with a bunch of kids, because I'm drained, I'm worn out. Whoa, what's here on my... Yeah, and then also, on top of that, everything, you're trying to give your baby, like, all the attention. Well, as for me, I'm speaking all of this in my perspective, you know, I try to give my baby all my attention, and as he should get all my attention, I'm his mama. He's the cutest. And so, you know, I'm just trying to have him live his best life, because I decided to bring him into this world, then he shall deserve the best life, the best childhood, you know? So as for that, you guys, now I've entered this era in my life, right? 8 months later, where I'm like, girl, what are you doing with yourself? Like, you need to get ready. I'm telling you guys, I've been stuck in sweats and sweaters, and I know, like, obviously there's been a storm and stuff, like, why would you want to go out anyways, but I've been stuck in sweats and sweaters for 8 months. Like, girl, come on. Like, you know, I've been going to therapy and it's been helping a lot, just talking about, like, because truly I truly feel like people didn't understand me. Like, I felt like I'm telling you guys, I felt like I was going crazy. Like, I truly, and it's so crazy because a lot of people are moms and they, like, don't really understand where I was coming from. And, you know, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna go to therapy because I really feel like I need to talk to someone about what I'm feeling. And on top of that as well, I was like, what I've learned in this spam of 8 months, or what I've learned overall as well, is that you just don't tell people your problems, right? You either talk to God about them, or, you know, get a therapist, because at the end of the day, you know, what is a therapist gonna do? That's their job, to listen. Are they gonna judge you? I mean, if you feel judged, then you can always go to a different therapist, but I just feel like that's just the route that I chose to take. And because, you know, I wasn't gonna tell people how I was feeling, you know, at that moment, because if they were not gonna understand, or if they weren't going to take the time to understand me when I was in a very vulnerable place in my life, which I had so much going on, you know, mentally, physically, like, and I felt like people outside of, obviously, my household, I felt like people expected so much from me still, like, and in my head I didn't really comprehend that, because I was like, I just gave birth, like, I'm a whole new mommy, what do people want from me, you know what I mean? So it was very hard for me, and I didn't really feel like really like explaining this to people, because I just felt like I was wasting my time. I was wasting my breath. I was wasting. But as of now, I'm obviously talking about it because I feel like I'm ready to talk about it. Or like I'm kind of updating you guys on what kind of went on for 8 months. And I was like thinking the other day, what happened? I was thinking the other day that my baby is going to be 1 year old. 1 year old, like, huh? What? In like 3 months, 4 months. What month are we, you guys? We're in March, right? March, April, May. Yeah, 4 months. And my birthday, you guys, I'm gonna be 25 in April, next month. Like, I'm 25 years old with a baby. Well, I'm gonna be 25 years old with a baby, with an almost 1 year old. Like, girl, what? I never thought in a million years I would be 25 years old with a baby. Never in a million years. But here I am. Here I am. A new chapter in my life. Even though 8 months ago it was a new chapter because my baby was born. But I feel like 8 months later, it's a new chapter. Meaning like just life in general. Like I feel so much different than I did going through postpartum. And I feel like I still have my days where I feel like very low, but I'm dealing with it. And I feel like I have to start somewhere, right? Like I have to start somewhere in like feeling good about myself. Like a lot of women, I feel like they don't really, it's so crazy because the people tell me like you snap back like right after pregnancy. I'm like, did I really snap back? Like, no, I don't think so. But, and then like, I honestly hate when people bring up my body. Like, what are you talking about? But I feel like the person that has gone through it, I feel like is only allowed to talk about their body. Like, I feel like I'm only allowed to talk about my body. Like, no one else. And I feel like vice versa. Like, if someone gave birth, like, I feel like they're only allowed to talk about their body. Because I think it's so rude when someone says like, I don't know, maybe it's just me, I don't know. I feel like it's so rude when someone tells me like, oh my god, you look, you snap back. Like, your butt looks so good. And I'm like, but like, they don't really know how that person feels like about their body. So like, why would you, I don't know. Maybe it's just me ranting at them. I'm throwing all my freaking postpartum clothes away. I'm gonna throw them away. I'm gonna throw away these freaking sweats. I'm gonna throw away all my sweats. I'm gonna throw away everything that makes me feel bummy. Like, because I really need to get back into the game. Like, I really need to get my style back. I really need to figure out what I like. Like, girl, oh my goodness. Truly, I do. And then also, you guys, I wanna, like, my baby's starting to get older. I know I haven't really introduced him on here. But I probably will, maybe in his 1 year, because I really want to start doing things with him as he gets older. I want to like do more activities with him, like outside, like, outdoor things. And I want to bring you guys along where I want to like document it, you know, like he's my baby. I want to come back to these like moments back when I'm like 80 or something. I want to go back and be like, that's my baby. And he is the funniest dude. He really is the funniest dude. I want to like bring you guys along, just like mommy things, self-care things, women things. Like, oh my gosh, it's just trying to be like a baddie is like really hard. But you're not a baddie naturally, like. But yeah, like some days I really don't have time, or I can't say that I don't have time. I have to make time to do my hair, to do my makeup, to really do all those things. So can't say I don't have time. I'm gonna clean and I'm gonna show you guys what I bought today. And a lot of the stuff, over time, if I ever show you guys things that I buy, I'm gonna link it into my storefront, which I will link down below for you guys to check out. Like any baby related things or like home decor, like I will link it in my storefront so you guys can check it out.
So I got this rug, you guys. Yes, I have a mess, so it's so cute. I'm gonna put it right here in the center. But yeah, I got this rug, and I also got this like hamper, but I have to like stuff it so it can actually go around. It is so cute, and I'm gonna link these in my storefront, so if you guys want to check that out. And I'm gonna have other things in there, but I love it. I love this one too. I will probably order another one. I actually got this one. I don't know if I want to put blankets in here or if I wanna use it for my baby's like clothes when I do laundry. So we'll see. Mister, you finished? Thank you. Hi, you're so cute. You're so cute. Hi. Did you finish? Aw, you're so smart. You're so smart.